Now to Pakistan. Prime Minister Imran Khan is battling twin challenges, a rocky marriage and an unstable government, and Pakistan is debating which will collapse first. Let me start from the beginning. Imran Khan's list of woes is long. In the last week alone, many developments have taken place and each has fueled the wave of opposition against the Prime Minister. Let's bring up some pictures on your screens, which are pictures of Pashtuns, hundreds of thousands of them. They are in North Waziristan, and this was a rally of the Pashtun civil rights movement. They were raising their voice against terrorists, mostly backed by the state. Look at their numbers. Why is this significant? Because of the sheer size and the scale of this protest and the level of their distress and anger. The Pashtuns are an ethnic minority in Pakistan. They make up nearly 15% of the country's population. They've been protesting for a while now, and the agitation has only intensified in the past few days. They call it the Pashtun Tehfuz movement. What do they want? They want basic rights and justice. The Pashtuns have been victims of discrimination. They've been victims of extrajudicial killings. They're often unfairly labeled as terrorists and drug dealers. For decades, they have faced oppression and abuse in Pakistan, and now they're speaking out and speaking out loudly. Imran Khan is a worried man because this isn't the only rally that has made news this week. The opposition seems to have found its voice too in Pakistan. These pictures that we'll just bring up for you are from a rally of Bilawal Bhutto Zardari. He is the leader of Pakistan People's Party. This crowd turned up to hear Bhutto. What was he saying? He was slamming the Prime Minister. Bilawal Bhutto called Imran Khan a puppet. He lashed out at the government for its economic policies. Did all of this have an impact? Yes, if not just one protest, then all things combined certainly did. The Pakistani Prime Minister had to make some adjustments. He ordered a major cabinet reshuffle today. Pakistan's Finance Minister Asad Umar has stepped down. And this is just before Pakistan begins crucial negotiations with the International Monetary Fund for a bailout. They need that money urgently. Reports say that the Petroleum Minister has also been sacked. Pakistan is in a state of flux. Its economy is in a shambles. The FATF is breathing down its neck, demanding action against terrorists. There is turmoil in Imran Khan's cabinet. People are unhappy with the performance of the government. Citizens are taking to the streets, and the opposition is smelling blood. Remember, Mr. Khan came to power less than a year ago on the promise of a Naya Pakistan. In December last year, he himself floated the theory of a midterm election. He has since then said that everything is fine, but that doesn't appear to be the case. It doesn't help that national TV stations in Pakistan are discussing his marriage. Amid reports that his third wife, Bushra, has left his Banigala residence in Islamabad and shifted to Lahore.